What's up, guys? Just checking in, middle of the week. All I'm doing here is replacing the exhaust clamp, but just wanted to show you the clamp to get from Deutsch Auto. Now my biggest VW sponsor. I mean, it always has been. That's my biggest GTI sponsor there for this particular car. So it is where I get almost all my parts, really. And this should be a 2.5 inch VW clamp. And you can just see the thickness and quality on this. I'm going to take off that band clamp, that $10 band clamp, and show you them side by side and just how much better quality this one is. No issues with the other one whatsoever, no leaks or anything, but I just want a really, really good clamp on that thing. And I think first time I got candy. I got a couple of Warheads. Let's see, apple and watermelon. Ooh, watermelon does sound interesting. And some Airheads. I actually prefer the Airheads, personally. Cherry Airhead is hard to beat. So thanks for the candy, Mr. Paul B, and your Rallycross wagon or stuff that I've been watching a little bit. Check out his site, Deutsch Auto Parts, or his YouTube channel for that rally wagon he's building. I heard that he broke it or something. Haven't had a chance to watch that one yet. Anyway, I'm just going to hop under here, get this clamp off. And for peace of mind, put this other one on. It's about 20-25 bucks, and the butt clamp that I bought was like 10, so for just twice the money, still not a lot of money, you get super high quality OEM clamp. That's why I'm doing it, just mainly for OCD reasons. So let me get that thing off. I think it's a 14 or a 15, maybe a 9/16, and I'll be right back. So I'll get the old one off. Now this has some rubber in it. It's a spark plug socket, so I can't really seat it all the way, but I'll be careful with it. It comes off really easy. Almost too easy. That's strange. All right, just gotta loosen each side. You know, one at a time, relieve the pressure, but that's why I'm really replacing it. It's a very thin, lightweight clamp, as we'll see. But yeah, that came off easier than I expected. And this will probably drop because it isn't really held too well in place without the clamp. It'll probably drop on me. Get this off. Don't want to cut my finger open on the sharp metal. There we go. Two pieces off, everything off. Yeah, I mean, look at the difference in that piece of tin versus solid. I might as well check if this thing fits while you're right here. So, let's see, I want this bolts on this side. See where I can angle it to get it started. Yeah, it looks pretty good. Bring that down. Oh, beautiful, beautiful. I already know, I hope, these are going to be 13s like every other VW sleeve clamp. 13s, and I like to torque these to 190 inch-pounds, which is probably 13.5 foot-pounds. Very light. You over-tighten these, that's when they'll bind up, and they'll get old from repeated use. You'll have to replace them. But this does look good. It looks like it does have a nice bit to tighten, so I'm not worried about the looseness. It's going to connect all the way through. And it's probably absolutely perfect. This is what it's made for, VW 2.5 inch pipe. So let me go ahead and get that centered up properly and get it snugged up a little bit. All right, guys, 190 inch pounds, don't do foot pounds. 190 inch pounds was absolutely perfect. Super solid. I can't even budge it. I mean, the other one was even super solid already. This one is just incredibly solid. Never really have to touch it again. I don't plan to mess with this cap back. It's restored for me the way I wanted it. One little note, interesting. You know, I stopped that ethanol. I'm not blending right now. And it's a relief, actually. It's just such a pain in the butt keeping those yellow VP bins over there stocked up. I have about a third of a yellow bin in there. I almost don't even want to use it. it's almost unusable power. It makes it leads to spin, where without the ethanol, it's still super fast, but it doesn't spin as much, and it keeps the power on the ground. Of course, you know, you get tires, a whole different ball game. But for now, the way the car is, I don't even want to deal with the hassle of a E85 blend, E30 blend, anything like that. So also, it was so much torque, and on turns from a stop with the wheel turned, you know, it was making so many more creaks in the suspension. It was even getting me nervous. It's just so much more power straining that suspension, and man, the VW suspension struggles. With the pothole deal, a lot of people are talking about lately, that's just a VW thing. They've always had the hard sprung cars, even from 1984 GTI. They're always very stiff in the suspension, not super jarring, but very taut. And combined with the tires and wheels of today, which weren't in the 80s, it makes for a bad combo, and so many people are getting cracked rims and potholes and bubbles. And it isn't an every car thing. It's a VW thing in the way they're set. So, I mean, there are plenty of ways you can fix it. Change the whole suspension to anything you like. Maybe some new shocks would even support those potholes a little better. Some stronger shocks, some Bilstein monotubes or something to really keep that nice and solid. But yeah, I'm still thinking about those 17-inch. I mean, I'll buy them as soon as I have any money. I do want 17-inch wheels for sure, for that reason that we just talked about. And some good Michelin 17-inch tires at some point is a dream for this. You may have seen little spatterings of Subaru WRX here and there in my posts. Sure, I miss it a bit. There's something special about Subarus, but there's also something special about GTIs. It's a very tough life when you love both of them equally. I keep thinking at this point, like, man, it'd be so great to be back in WRX. But when I was in my WRX, all I could think about was it'd be so great to be in a GTI. So it's a never-ending circle. And my dream, if I was like a big channel somewhere, I would love to have a GTI and a WRX in my garage. Both would be the absolute dream. My two favorite cars of all time. So maybe when I retire or something, or when the kids move out, I can have that dream and have my two favorite dream cars and mod them both and have this insane garage, even though I'll be like 60, 70 years old by then. Anyway, because of those weird noises on the creaking I heard lately with all that power and the potholes I hit, I do want to just inspect my front suspension a little bit, so I'll be doing that in the next day or two. I just read a post today about someone that actually cracked their shock, how their spindle that the shock goes into from a pothole. It actually had a crack, not on the side that's open that you know about, but on the back side, a crack just from the impact. And not that I think it happened, but I just want to inspect everything because I'm getting weird clunky things. The car has 7,000 miles on it. The suspension should not be, the bushing shouldn't be getting old yet. They shouldn't be getting soft. They shouldn't be half worn out, you know, 7,000 miles. So I'm gonna do an inspection like everybody should do, like you all should do every once in a while. Just get a big light under that front end, get it up in the air, nice and clean. And just inspect your sway bar end links especially, those are real thin. And just look around your spindle if you've hit some potholes. Inspect everything, you know, see what you can find. That's about it. I don't really have anything planned. That exhaust clamp was my huge mod of the week. That was it. That was my mod money of the week. So I'm closing in on $100 here toward the next mod. I don't even know what I want, to be honest. Well, I do. I want wheels. The little mods that are on my list, I just wouldn't even get enjoyment buying them and installing them. So I may just skip some of the little schmizzle smazzle and hold out to get something I want, you know, something I'll get excited about. Not just a little piddly mod, OEM jack kit for the bottom. That's such a boring thing to buy, you know. All right, enough rambling. That's all I did today. Just checking in with you as the channel is slow. Doing my best to come up with content, but as you can tell, it's getting pretty hard. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for keeping up. We're approaching 20,000 subscribers. That's going to be an exciting day, I guess. It'll just be, whoa, okay, I hit it. Now, you know, what's next? So anyway, big milestone coming. Yeah, I am proud of it. It's been 11, 12 years. Anyway, keep watching. GTI for now, if you like it. Someday, probably back to Subaru. We'll see. Never-ending journey. Money is always the obstacle, isn't it? In all our lives. I'll see you guys later.